Jesus, you are unfairly accused and put on trial for performing the works of your Father. Pilate knows that you have done nothing wrong, but he goes against his better judgment and gives in to the pressure of the crowd. He washes his hands, saying, "I am innocent of this righteous man's blood. See to it yourselves." How quick are we to condemn those in our own lives? A simple disagreement. Those we work with, our family, our friends. When we condemn those around us, we turn away from God's love, shading the light of hope and turning it to darkness. In many countries, people are persecuted for expressing their faith publicly. Yet, how many times do we deny our faith or condemn those who do not share our views? Father, give us the courage to hear your will and to obey it as Jesus did. Let us pray for those who are persecuted for their beliefs. We also pray for the imprisoned and those who feel the chains of restraint emotionally and physically, that we may share the light of hope with our neighbors, now and always. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. You are forced to carry it through the streets while being mocked, laughed at, and ridiculed. Some even denied knowing you. How painful that must have been. We experience many crosses in our lives, fears, worries, frustrations. Many of us carry our crosses with us daily. They weigh us down. They burden us. They prevent us from being able to care for others and to love unconditionally. Yet, we are strengthened with the knowledge that Jesus promised to be near us at all times. And so, as he carried his cross, let us bear ours, knowing that Jesus once again helps us to carry it. Let us pray for those who are carrying heavy crosses, for those who feel they are carrying their cross alone. May Christ lift those who have buckled under the weight of their failures and personal challenge. Many people watched as you struggled to carry your cross alone. The pain you suffered from your scourging along with the weight of the cross caused you to fall. How many times have we fallen on the journey? Every day we struggle under the weight of life's challenges. While we may stop or give up, you continued on. Let us pray for the ways we fall in our lives. Through struggles with addictions, compulsive behaviors, bad habits, and other sinful actions, that we may be lifted up each time we fall. Through prayers and tangible actions, may we seek the counsel needed to stand up and walk again. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Imagine the pain that Mary must have felt, knowing that she couldn't do anything to help you. Mary walked the path to the cross, standing faithfully beside you as you lived the Father's will. How might we be like Mary in our journey to the cross? Lord, we know how difficult it is for parents, especially for those who are faced with difficult decisions. We pray that our community will embrace the importance of family life and encourage and lift each other up during difficult times. We also pray and give thanks for the gift of parents who guide us in our faith and journey with us through our lives. Let us pray for parents and all those who will act as guardians of faith, hope, and love throughout our lives. Let them look to Mary and the example she was throughout the life of Christ, and strive to emulate that in their day-to-day life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This was not a job that he asked for, or an honor that he sought. Do we consider helping others an honor? Do we look for ways to use our acts of charity for our own benefit? Are we good stewards of God's many gifts, reaching out to serve the poor and suffering among us? Just as Simon helped Jesus, perhaps we are called to seek those who we can help, not just as a special favor, but as a way of life each and every day. We pray for all those who are in need. May we offer our gifts without condition. Make us serve as beacons of hope to those in need physically, emotionally, and spiritually. We pray to the Lord.
Lord.
Tradition tells us that through an act of kindness, Veronica was blessed to receive your image imprinted on the cloth that she used to wipe your brow. When we reach out to another person in pain, we are blessed with your image also. Yet, at times, it is easier to pretend that those people are not our problem. Their struggle is not something that we caused. Why should we be concerned with them? Ah, Lord, help us wipe the faces of those suffering and comfort the sick. May we take the time today to let those close to us know how important they are in our lives, wiping their tears with a kind word. Jesus, the more you walked, the more difficult your journey became. Even though you had someone there helping you, the pain caused you to fall again. Oftentimes, we fail at living our faith each day, whether it be giving in to physical temptation, making hurtful comments to those who are different than us, or by ignoring injustice taking place around us. We seem to forget our faith and we fall. Yet, even when we fall time and again, you are there offering forgiveness if we are willing to accept it. When you kept going after your fall, you showed us how to pick ourselves up and continue on. Let us pray for the times when we have failed, for our personal struggles. May we rise up from the falls of life and continue on the journey. seeking forgiveness and learning from our mistakes. You spoke to the women of Jerusalem on your way to Calvary. You told them to weep for themselves and their children. You knew that mankind had much to be sorrowful for. You wished for them to recognize their own pilgrimage rather than to lament yours. Jesus, help us to realize our situation today. We take from what the world has to offer us with no regard for the future. What happens when this world has no more to give? We should be weeping for the future that we are creating for ourselves and our children with our selfishness and greed. We must remember to be in the world, but not of the world. We pray for the courage and strength to overcome our selfishness and to put aside temptations of the flesh in order to unite ourselves more perfectly to the will of God. Overcome with exhaustion, you collapsed a third time on your way to Calvary, and a third time you pulled yourself to your feet and moved on, even though it would have been so easy for you to give up. That was the example you were giving to us. In the face of pain and death, you continued to move forward. You refused to give up. You remained faithful. We all go through difficult times, trying to fit in, striving to be successful, and other problems the world throws our way. We must continue our journey when we fall, being faithful to God. Let us pray for the difficult times we may be going through, whether it is with stress or not finding answers to the daily questions that torment us, our financial difficulties, or whatever else may be weighing on us. May God watch over us and help us know the light of hope and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
When you finally reached the place where you were crucified, your tormentors were not satisfied with the humiliation you had already suffered. They took your clothes and cast lots for them, the only things you had left. They even failed to recognize your dignity as a person. There are times when we fail to acknowledge the dignity of people. We sometimes forget the elderly, the homeless, and the lonely among us, ignoring their cry for companionship. How little effort it would take if we all worked together to make these lives a little brighter. We pray for those who have been stripped of their garments physically, emotionally, and mentally, for those in our midst who have been abandoned, who have known no love, who return home each day feeling so incredibly alone, that we may recognize their dignity and offer respect, remembering that we are all created in the image and likeness of God, our Creator. As the nails pierced your flesh, you remained faithful. As the hammer fell again and again, you would not reject your faith. You did not reject doing the will of the Father. We pray for the times when we are pinned into making a choice for the faith or not. Help us to choose our faith Help us to not be trapped by the expectations of the world. And help us. Help us to do your will. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As you hung on the cross, you cried out, my God, why have you forsaken me? But in the next breath, you said, Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. Even through feeling abandoned, you continued to have faith in the Father's will. How often do we turn to God when we feel alone in our struggles? Do we trust that He has a plan for us? We might even cry out in anguish, my God, why have you forsaken me? Can we, like Christ, in the next breath, give our will over to the Father by saying, into your hands I commend my spirit. Let us pray that through the trials and tribulations of life, when we feel abandonment and as though there's nobody to turn to, we may continue to entrust ourselves to the Father's will, just as Jesus did from the cross. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Just as Joseph of Arimathea went above and beyond to care for Jesus, we are also called to go above and beyond in spreading the love and joy of Christ to all of our brothers and sisters. Do we try and get along and away with doing the minimum requirement? How do we spread the love and joy of Christ? We pray for all those gathered here tonight, that we may live a faith of action and be messengers of the good news as we continue on this journey. May we find strength, guidance, peace, and support from our faith and from each other. We pray to the Lord.